Welcome back, everybody, to Let's Play Pikmin 2. Heading back to the Valley of Repose, first area of the game. That means there's more than one area, if you couldn't tell. Who wants to hear more complaining? Yay! Oh, after this cutscene. Good morning, workers. Ready for another day of toiling for the profit of your company? Okay. That's a weird way of putting it. Toiling. They're not lazy, they're obedient. They come out when I say to. You hear like a weird noise, it's like, aww. But we're gonna take out all our Pikmin, because why the heck would we not want to take out all our Pikmin? You know what, that flower is gonna grow later, so take care of that later. So yeah, more complaining. My muscles are really sore. It seriously hurts to lift my arm. And in addition to that, if that wasn't already, you know, bundles of fun, I also hurt my thumb really bad. How did this happen? Because I fell asleep with my hand under my chest, and it like drove my nail into my thumb, so now I've got like all this tissue damage on my thumb, and there's like this line going across it. That's right, come to my videos for lots of graphic descriptions. What fun. But seriously, my thumb hurts a lot. My thumb muscle also hurts too. Yeah, so I'm just a big bundle of pain today. We're not here to talk about pain, we're here to talk about Pikmin. These are red Pikmin. They're adorable, so love them. I don't know where I'm going with that, so stay there. We're gonna need you. Yeah. Sorry, I haven't played this in a while. So, yeah, when you pluck Pikmin, it's always best to use two people, because it goes twice as fast, obviously. Pluck those Pikmin away. Oh, well. And here we got that pellet ready. Why is this one so far behind? They were like right next to each other, weren't they? Oh. Whoops. That's not what I was trying to do. Wow, we got a lot of Pikmin. Why does it feel like I have more Pikmin on like this time than last time? That's weird. Why am I missing some? Where are they? Yeah, this is a little radar they got. It says they're right here. Oh, duh, I threw them up here. Of course they're gonna be over here, because that's where I put them. Oh, actually, yeah. So, we're gonna have them bring that stuff over there for more Pikmin. And this guy, be very careful with him. Okay. But, we're gonna wanna bring this back. Why? Because if we fight that guy, we might lose so many Pikmin that we can't carry that back. although it's never happened, even though I fought him first like a million times before, but, you know, I just want to be sure about it and whatnot. So we got more Pikmin to pluck. Hurry up. Yeah, the more Pikmin that carry it, you know, the faster it goes, obviously. But I don't have to explain that. Also, something that I didn't mention in the first video. Which, you know, my subscribers already know, but just for you newcomers, I'd like to say I'm not copying Chugga Conroy, so leave me alone. Just had to say that now. Just had to say that now. Yeah, because I actually beat the game before he even had a copy of it. And I planned on doing a Let's Play of it before he had a copy of it. How would I know? Because he told everybody on Twitter when he got it. So, that's how I know. And before you call me a liar, you know, you can look back on my previous videos before he announced it, and I'm sure I'll say something about Pikmin 2 in one of those videos. So anyways, we're gonna have a different strategy than the last game. We're just gonna throw them all on there. My thumb hurts. Don't eat any Pikmin or I'll kill you. I so did not lose those Pikmin. You dirty liar. The game is a liar. But anyways, while they're bringing that stuff back, we're actually gonna have the rest of the Pikmin work on tearing down this. We're gonna have Olimar stick around there, and we're gonna escort these guys back. I'll meet you when everything's all set and ready. Okay, I'm back. I plucked all the Pikmin, and they're gonna help on destroying the gate, which will make it go a little faster. It's almost torn down, as you can see. And we got a cutscene. How could Pikmin destroy such a massive wall? Because big things come from little packages, I guess. Like an envelope filled with money. Or even just a dollar. I mean, like, get a $100 bill. I mean, look how small that is. Worth $100. You can buy a whole bunch of stuff with that. Or as in my case of collecting video games, you know, you could buy, like, not a lot with that. You want a Atari 2600? Oh, too bad, it's $300. Yeah, seriously, those, you know, old video game stuff that I like, you know, it's expensive. I want an Atari, but it's expensive, so have to wait till I get a job. I should get any day now. Because I'm out of school, and everybody is going back to school. So that gives me an advantage. I can work, you know, whenever, and everybody else is limited, so that'll probably help out. My heat sensors indicate this hole's interior is warmer than on the surface. Okay. I'm sorry if I don't read it like a professional or whatever. Probably not even read most of the stuff. But anyways, because this dungeon, yeah, they introduced dungeons in this game. Because this dungeon is so short, I'm not gonna, like, excuse me, computer, you can stop making noise. Oh yeah, I'm not gonna split the video because it's really short, so. Plus there's a couple things to cut out. Yay, more product placement. Quenching emblem. You know, I've never had 7-Up. Is it good? Tell me if it's good. I don't know, everybody's got an opinion. My taste buds are different. My voice gives me inner strength. Yeah, this is a treasure. Pretty sure that, dead animals are treasure. When you fry them up, get some, barbecue sauce, you eat them, that's some serious treasure right there. Especially if they're, like, you know, steak or something. Stuff's delicious. From what I remember, I don't know, I haven't had steak in forever. Citrus lump! And we're just gonna head down into the next level. Usually dungeons have, like, hazards, like fire or water or whatever, but, okay, 5 minutes later, sorry about that little interruption, you can recall, adjust the camera, we already know this, excuse me computer, you can stop making clicking sounds, it's quite awkward, but anyway, we're gonna go into sub-level 2, with all our adorable Pikmin and whatnot, why do I keep calling them adorable. I have problems with calling things adorable. And that's right, sub-level 2 is the final floor. I know, plot twist, right? But anyways, we got something here. It's a globe. Half of it. You know, everybody's all like, the disadvantage of using a globe is you can only see one side at a time. And, like, does anybody ever, like, think of using a mirror? Like, you can see both sides if you have a mirror. Everybody's all like, no, that messes it up. Ah. Because I remember one time in school, we were doing something like comparing maps to globes, you know, which one is better, and that was one of the things, and I'm like, you could just use a mirror, but whatever. Anyways, we need 101 Pikmin, but you can only have 100 Pikmin on the field at one time. So, we must find a solution. We must find powerful Pikmin beyond all belief. And since you've probably seen both the box and the intro to the video and the intro to the game when you turn the game on, you probably know that it's probably not white Pikmin because they're so skinny, it's purple Pikmin. Yeah, they're not spoilers if you already know they exist. But yep, Pikmin that are purple are awesome. And yeah, they call these violet candy pop buds. Why not purple? I don't know. They're purple Pikmin. Why? I don't know. It doesn't make much sense. And they know the art of sumo wrestling. Yeah. So very heavy, very strong. Entirely new type. Yes, I know we're, you know, Olimar's horrible. He didn't mention this in his last report because he didn't find them because he didn't go underground. But, yeah. Each purple Pikmin has the power of 10. So we don't need 100. We just need a couple purples to even things out. Throughout the game, we're gonna need a total of 100 purple Pikmin, which can be very difficult to obtain, since if you keep, like, going down into this dungeon, those won't respawn, or rather, they might respawn, like, once or twice, but after a little while, yeah, they're gone for good, and you're gonna have to find somewhere else to get them. Normally, somewhere that's most difficult. Move faster, Pokey. Faster. 100 seconds. What? Okay, yeah, I should stop that. But yay, we got 200 Pokos and the Spherical Atlas. Okay, so basically, because we got the Spherical Atlas, we now have unlocked a new area in the game, which is good because there's nothing we can do here. I'm just gonna leave those guys behind. And yeah, when you go down into a different part of the dungeon, or you exit the dungeon, you have all the Pikmin come with you, even if they're not, like, with you. They can be anywhere in the dungeon. They're still gonna be right there. And this is how you exit dungeons, geysers. Even though Pikmin drown, I guess this doesn't count for whatever reason. Astounding! Not really. I mean, it's just a geyser, really. Really. I should stop saying really. And so here's where Nintendo logic comes in. Not only do the Pikmin not drown, even though if they, like, so much as touch water, they pretty much drown. It's coming up in a second. By the way, I'm gonna collect a lot of the enemy bodies because eventually it does add up to get a lot of money. Unlike a lot of people who just ignore them except for, like, the boss bodies or what the bosses leave behind, because, I mean, it adds up a lot towards the end, so. So, yeah, this is where Nintendo logic kicks in. You land right at the base. No matter what, you land right at the base. How does that even happen? Successfully return to the planet's surface. Excellent decision-making, gentlemen. Was it really our decision? I mean, there was no other way to get out. What other options did we have, really? Imagine if you went into a dungeon, you got to the bottom, and there was no geyser. They'd be like, oopsies. Yeah, that's also more Nintendo logic. By the way, we just ended a cutscene to start into second cutscene. Okay, apparently we don't realize it, but we're exhausted, even though I wanna still play this game. But apparently we're exhausted, so. Haste makes waste. So, the more you hold in your poop, the dirtier it gets? I don't know. Trying to make some kind of joke, but whatever. I don't know what it was gonna be. And the purple Pikmin shrink and then go and get sucked inside the ship. That's not even Nintendo logic. That's just what the heck just happened logic. So as usual, fly up into outer space. And from now on, we'll be able to have regular days. Unlike this time where once a certain thing happens, the day it's just done. But anyway, we got lots of monies. You cannot do any better than this by this day. So, once this happens, yeah. Nothing you can do about it. Baby steps first. Plan well. Yep, I hope to plan well. I really do. Planning well. What am I talking about? I don't know. I just sort of zoned out and started talking. But anyways, next time on Let's Play Pikmin 2, we're going to the Awakening Wood. Because there's nothing to do in the Valley of Repose. And yeah, we'll see what mysteries await us there. So, see you next time.